Hey guys, what is up? Glyn here, and today I'm bringing you a kind of tutorial on how to play Eldar. It's mainly going to be me showing you generally my build for early game, and then kind of how I'd go into approaching late game. So if you're new to Dawn of War, or you play Eldar normally and you're just looking for tips, I think will probably explain a lot more about how to kind of gain the upper hand, especially in early game, because Eldar have a extremely strong early game. So here I've got a replay of me versus a hard AI. They're not generally, the hard AI isn't too bad. Harder is, they have quite strong rushes, so that'd probably be more of a challenge. I basically just went for it because it's kind of, you know what to expect from it, so I could show you a decent idea of how a game might progress. So yeah, I'm playing Eldar, this is me here, and my opponents are Space Marines. So basically, I didn't know this at the time because I was playing random, but I know Space Marines are going to bring out quite a bit of ranged. They won't really have good melee early game because they can't build their Raptor squads, especially in the first kind of stages. They need to upgrade their stronghold, I believe. So I'm basically going to go for my normal build, which is essentially, if I play this now, I'll quickly hit BA and build an aspect portal, and straight away I'll get out another Bone Singer. Mainly because Bone Singers build extremely fast, so you won't have to worry about messing up your requisition catcher. I then obviously go for two Garden Squads, and these are going to be my main catcher assistants. I've got the aspect portal building and a plasma generator queued up so I can get some more power. We will fulfill a duty. And as you can see, I've got my Guardian Squad coming out, capturing the nearest possible requisition point I can. As I've got my aspect portal built, I'm now upgrading up the Banshee aspect, which is basically going to allow me to get Howling Banshees, which, as well as being able to capture requisition points, they are going to be a very powerful force in attacking my foe, as you will see soon. If you look on your normal infantry, you'll see that they have a melee and a ranged damage, as you can see here. Howling Banshees are primarily melee. They will not do any range damage, but they will do a ton of melee damage. Basically, it gets like these guys, like scout squads. You will find that they have quite a high range, well, fairly high, not in terms of late game, but they have quite a low melee power in significance. So basically what you can do is you can tangle up your Howling Banshees with any ranged units, and they'll immediately be at a great disadvantage because their range damage will be zilch once you've engaged them in melee. As you can see here, these guys are going to switch to melee pretty soon. At this point, I see these guys bring out a Space Marine squad, which, as you can see, are a lot more powerful. They're heavy infantry, so I'm going to back off my guys. Now I've got a Guardian squad here and another Howling Banshee squad coming in. I'm going to tangle up one squad, the scout squad, with my Howling Banshees coming in, and this Space Marine squad with my Howling Banshees. I've only got three of them at the moment, I believe, in the squad. But as you can see, they have a ridiculously high melee attack. These guys, in comparison, have pretty much essentially the same, but Howling Banshee squads tend to have higher squad numbers. So as you can see, I have 4v4, I've got a high melee, I'm obviously at an advantage here. Unfortunately, they're now bringing in an extra Space Marine squad, which are going to add a lot of range damage in. My Guardian squad's taking care of their Scout squad. They're pretty much at equal strength, but I had greater numbers to begin with. I've tangled up this spare Scout squad here, but since this new Space Marine squad is coming in, I'm tangling up them with my Howling Banshees too. Basically, you want to prioritize their highest damage ranged units with your Howling Banshees, and then deal with that. Over here, in the meanwhile, I've been building Listening Shrines with my Bone Singers. You can teleport these about, which makes it really handy for building them. And I've just left it with the Howling Banshee upgrade on my Aspect Portal. At the moment, I only have four squads. I have these two Guardian squads and these two Howling Banshee squads. And obviously, my Howling Banshees are my main driving force, seeing as my Guardian squads are pretty much the same strength as Scouts. Now here, I'm a little confused at where to attack, because these guys will not be able to take down buildings very easily. So I basically just want to... I decided to prioritize barracks, because once you get the barracks down, obviously they can't build any more Space Marine squads. I'm also going after their builders to disrupt their... basically I'm trying to stop them from doing anything at the moment, which is probably the better tactic. Over here, I've been running out of resources, but I managed to build a Farseer. As you can see, I've got a little bit. I've managed to get all my add-ons to my listening shrines. I do not have the central relic. Mainly at this point, I didn't want to like take anyone away from this fight, and so I am basically going to leave that in the entire game. If I change the speed of this, as you can see, I'm slowly getting wearing them down, trying to kill all their servitors, which I managed to do. At this point, they start being a little more clever, upgrading their listening posts. And listening posts actually do a fair amount of damage. They're probably maybe about like a scout squad, bit stronger than a scout squad. Once upgraded, obviously they have quite a bit of health, so for stack defense, they're actually not too bad. The main thing here was I got my... They started attacking the Guardian Squad first, and it's going to be really effective against the Guardian Squad because they have pretty low health. They're pretty weak. They're like Imperial Guard squads. And so I backed these guys out, and then I took my Farseer back in, and now my Farseer is tanking all the damage, which is probably a better strategy. I've got a Webway Gate up here, and I've also got one here so I can port in units pretty quick. And I've got this support platform just because I had the spare resources, and I figured anything come out of here is just going to get shut up by my support platforms. So now we keep going up with this. They do start pushing forwards to try and get my units out of there. They build a chaplain, and now they're just going to start ramming out scout squads, but I've got too much infantry here, as well as these support platforms. I'm tangling the chaplain up in melee, just because if he gets in the middle of my range squads, he's going to mess them up. And I managed to get him down. So the match pretty much continues as you would like expect it to. They get another listening post up here, so I tangle that up with my melee. Melee are okay against taking down buildings. Eldar do not have a very good anti-building, but obviously as you can see, anti-infantry is very strong, especially in the early game. And yeah, Annihilation. So this is a entirely different game that I played with a bunch of friends of a LAN. And in this game, we basically have like a variety of experience of players as well as races. We've got quite a lot of Necrons. Necrons are pretty much a favorite. Tau, more Necrons. Imperial Guard, surprisingly. And yeah, more Necrons. So yeah, Necrons like are generally considered probably the strongest race in Dawn of War, which is mainly why I like to play Eldar, because Eldar are pretty much the perfect counter for Necrons. Necrons are very slow moving, whereas Eldar can move around a lot. They can teleport their buildings. Necrons can't. They're pretty much vulnerable if they leave their stuff sitting around. But they are also very powerful. Obviously, they're mainly ranged too, so my early game melee advantage is going to do a lot of damage. I'd like to point out that most of these people aren't nearly as good as me, so it's going to be a little biased in the sense that, especially this person playing here, is a completely new player, so has the tutorial experience. That's it. The guy over here is pretty good, and so is the Tau player. Everyone else is fairly standard. Probably your average newbie. So let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to go with my standard build. Get an aspect portal out, Bone Singer, two Guardian Squads, and Fleet of Foot. I forgot to mention it before that I do tend to get Fleet of Foot as well, especially on larger maps. Smaller maps, it's not so much of a big deal. But on larger maps, you can activate it pretty much any unit, and it will give them a speed bonus. They'll be really inaccurate whilst they're using Fleet of Foot, so remember to turn it back off again when you engage using F. Similarly, you can turn it back on really fast using F too. So though I've got my aspect portal out, I'm not really focusing as much, so my build order is slightly slower. I haven't... There goes the Banshee aspect add-on. Slightly too late. But hey, call it down to nerves. These guys are gonna go to my far end, start catching up there. There's two Bone Singers doing a lovely job. As you can see, she's not really doing much because she's new. This guy's doing nothing at all. This guy's doing a little bit. He needs to work on his power output though. And Tau are busy going away. This guy's also not too bad. As you can see, he's already got his summoning call coming up. plasma generators. Imperial Guard's doing alright, they've got the plasma generators going up, which is going to help him really well late game. And as you can see, this guy's not too bad either. So I've now got my guarding squads moving out. I want to try and expand my vision, see what people are up to. I'm penned in by two of the opposing team. As you can see, the rest of my team is over here. So it's not looking good for me right now. Obviously, I've got my Aspect Stone here, and my Howling Banshee's coming out. It's going to be big help. I'm using my Guardian Squad to catch these things. I should be using Fleet of Foot on that. As I want my Banshees on the front line, seeing as they are my pretty much my primary damage unit. Guardians add a little bit, but they're very vulnerable. You can take out a Guardian Squad really quickly. They do not have much health at all. I would pretty much, if I could, I'd use all Howling Banshees. But, you know, Guardian Squads are good at the beginning because they're cheap and they're good for capturing. They're really quick. You can just, like, have them running around the map whilst your Banshees do the fighting. So these guys are up here. I've built a Webway Gate, and I'm going to build Shroud just in case it happens that I need to kind of hide whilst I'm fighting. In case they early game rush and forget like an observation unit, so I can hide whilst I recover. I'm having a little look at what these guys are doing. This guy's got two Necron warriors out, which is why, as you can see, he does not have any stuff up, because he's basically gone straight for Necron warriors, which is a very bad idea. Obviously it worked there, but in the long run he needs that power to do anything. So yeah, I'm grabbing a relic here, which is going to help me a lot. There is four relics around the map. That's one here, one there, and so four critical locations. Nobody really pays attention to them, but there's three of them. Scattered around. There's not one here, which is kind of weird. They're clustered around that side. So yeah, this player has Scarabs out, Necron Warrior. Not the Necron Lord quite yet, but I feel it's coming out soon. Imperial Guard's doing alright, capturing as much possible. They've got a Tactical Command Control up, which is going to have all their upgrades for Imperial Guard. You might wonder why they don't have a Barracks, but that's because Field Command can produce these Guardsmen. Barracks produce Guardsmen. If you're only using Guardsmen early game, you don't really need it. It's kind of like a waste. So I think this turret is glitched. But he's building some early game defences just so he can mainly, I think, just provide cover on this little choke point here. Not entirely sure why he didn't build it closer. I guess he's trying to like also defend from that side. As you can see, there's a bunch of Necron warriors heading out there. One of the best early game units. I would advise getting the Necron Lord out early too. This guy probably should have more plasma generators. I've pretty much massed all my units up here. I'm filling in a pretty safe place. I've got my resource generation pretty much capped off. I have a thumb pile going up, and yeah, it's not looking too bad. At the moment, I'm pretty much like, I know there's a large Necron force up there, because I wandered over there before, so I'm probably going to head downwards, because I feel, I actually kind of took advantage here in that I knew this was a weaker player, and obviously being penned in, I needed to gain either somewhere to kind of run to, or just some extra resources. So definitely attacking a weaker player, though it's like unsportsmanly, it's going to be a big advantage. So now I know these guys are trying to catch my point from me, I believe. I think they've already decapped that. So I'm going to run these guys over here, I believe. Yes. And these Scarabs are not going to last long as soon as these Howling Banshees are like engaged. Once they've once they've got there, obviously I disengage Fleet of Foot. If they'd have run, you can always catch up with Fleet of Foot. Melee units, I don't think they take much accuracy damage from Fleet of Foot. It's mainly like ranged, I believe, that take the damage. So I've kind of capped this, just in case anyone comes over here. I don't really want them to notice this, or at least be able to destroy it. So it's basically like a cheap trick against people who don't take observation units that can detect infiltrated Also, if you upgrade this and they run by without any detection, so yeah, like what I'm doing now with the War Shrine, that's gonna like be doing damage whilst they can't see it, which is kind of cool. I've got an extra squad of Howling Banshees, I believe. Now I've got a fairly powerful force, especially if, like, for example, I could take on 3 Necron Warrior squads, engage them with my Howling Banshees all, and have my Guardians shooting at them, and they would not last long. My main issue is going to be fighting Necron Lords. These Necron Lords are, if you haven't played with them before, I think they're overpowered. I love them to bits, but they have very strong melee. I'll see if I can find one for you. See, 111 to 133 melee as compared to 41. They also have a okay range damage, which makes them really hard to kill. They have a large amount of health, 1,800. They can teleport, and you can upgrade them with artifacts and all that. So, yeah, they hurt. They hurt a lot. See, she's already got her Necron Lord up, who's going to pay a pain in the ass. The main tactic for dealing with a Necron Lord is engage them with a squad of Howling Banshees and just keep them busy. Get your Guardian squads out of the way, keep them busy with melee units, and just keep reinforcing your melee units. Do not worry about them too much. Melee units are generally okay with taking care of them. I need to move that Guardian squad out of the way, otherwise it's just going to get decimated. As you can see, it just one-shots that guy. They are not fun at all. Try and surround him with melee units. I need to be pulling that Guardian squad out. Now he's attacking the Guardian squad. As you can see, 3 Guardian squads on him. It's not going to take long to take him down, luckily. A smart player would be teleporting it away by now. Obviously a new player. This is, Imperial Guard comes to the rescue. But unfortunately it's a bit too late. Imperial Guard versus melee. Imperial Guard, 13 to 15 melee versus 41 to 58 melee. Yeah. Imperial Guard, fighting against Banshees, you really want some grenade launchers especially. And to be running away all the time. Imperial Guard don't take much of an accuracy bonus whilst running away. So you can just literally mess with Howling Banshees by just running away, keeping them out of the way. It's heavy bottle turret coming up here, but it's going to be too late. This guy is already dead. I've teleported in a Bone Singer up here. Luckily, there's a Necron Warrior squad, which I think is going to take down my Bone Singer. I've got some Builder Scarabs coming in here, which I didn't notice at the time. Very sneaky move. And yeah, I've managed to kill that. Luckily, they've ignored my Bone Singer, so I'm able to get this Web Warrior up. And once this is up, I can just teleport in as much stuff as I want. I can cloak it so they can't see it. And it's going to basically support me in taking over their base. Imperial Guard, I pretty much wiped out their entire army. Obviously, they've got some more stuff coming up here. This was actually probably a good move, putting this heavy bottle here, because it can just destroy anything he builds around here. Yeah. He's upgraded quite a lot on his power. Generally going into late game. He's getting the mechanized command, which is going to be a huge help. And yeah, but obviously this player's... In terms of this, they've got these guys here, which probably should be moving out. This guy's got lots that he's just doing nothing with. If you spend the whole game having your army in one place just doing nothing, don't. Throw it against someone. So now we can teleport these guys across. Probably I've got a file seer in there, maybe? Yes. So that's coming out and helping with these guys. We have... Yeah, nothing else much happening. I've put a Bone Singer in this guy's base, just in case I need to back off. I'm literally kind of paranoid about these guys ganging up on me. If they'd early game rushed me, especially with 2 Necron players either side, I would be dead. I'd have to, like, back out. They would have claimed this area. And yeah, as you can see, we're all extremely mature players. Okay. So yeah, Imperial Guard tried to make a foothold in here to kind of help the Necron player. It's just not working out. They're spreading themselves too thin. They have got this heavy bottle turret here. For some reason he's keeping his tech priest there. Not sure why. I think he's just forgotten about it. And obviously I've got my support platforms out, which is pretty much what I did last time. I like adding support platforms just because you tend to have quite a bit of requisition by this point, so you've got quite a lot there. I've got my Sorcerer up, which is going to do some really good upgrades. You've got reinforced armor and the Call of War research. Call of War basically makes Howling Banshees a lot more powerful than they already are, which is saying something. I'll have to show you the stats when that research is complete, which will be in just a tick. I'm building a support portal, which is going to give me my vehicles. As you can see, I've got a fairly big army now. Most of them have leaders on them now, as you can see. I've got the Warlocks here, and the Exarchs somewhere, I think. Maybe, I think they're all dead. Okay. We've also got Dark Reapers, which are pretty much, as you can see, heavy infantry. They're pretty much kind of like Space Marine squads. But you get more members to start. Wow. They're fairly, slightly cheaper, I think. And now the Call of War research is done, as you can see by their blue things. Pretty much their melee damage has gone up by about 1.5%, maybe 2. Kind of, not quite 2, I believe, maybe like 1.8. And their armor rating has also gone up. Not entirely sure where I can see that. But yeah, they're now heavy infantry. Woo! Alright.
Thank you for delivering us safely.
So, I've got back up here. I tend to focus on a mainly infantry Eldar army, and then my vehicles are more like an afterthought. So I'm getting fire dragons out to deal with any vehicles. This actually turns out to be a big mistake at the moment. I'm getting mobilized for war so I can get my backup vehicles. I tend to think of Eldar vehicles as more support roles. As you can see here, they're getting the heavy weapons teams up, but I can literally just rush them with my Howling Banshees and destroy them before really they have a chance to win damage. Fire Dragon's coming in handy here, as they're just going to take down this building really fast. Well, I've got my Necron allies doing... He's got a significant army and a significant like power structure, but he's also not really moving out and doing a lot. This is the main mistake of most early players. They'll play very, very defensive, stick to their bases, and be very afraid of the unknown. You basically, I'd advise you early game just to fight. This is another common mistake of Imperial Guard players. Commander squads have a really powerful melee, but they're also really weak. So what it's kind of better to do in some ways is switch them to range, not build like priests, build maybe like one priest. He's got two commissars, which is generally probably what I'd go for. And yeah, they're going to be extremely weak, especially if you focus fire on them. Even the... I can't remember how much health the commander has, but it's not that much. Also, their melee and range damage is kind of... Range damage is quite significant, so it's probably even better to use your range damage than your melee damage. You generally want to keep your commander alive and use like abilities like the Psycho ability has some really nice powers for taking out Necron Lords as like units, like single unit abilities, and they can also like decimate a whole squad with lightning and all that good stuff. So yeah, I basically just avoided these defenses completely here. Unfortunately, I've left it too long. We are 14 minutes in. If this was a real Necron player, he would have like he'd be on his kind of tier 3 vehicles by now and have car skins and ogrins, so kind of like in that sense he's pretty much spent all his money and time trying to save this player who's now dead and I've stolen her stuff. But he does have these two hellhounds out here which are going to be extremely powerful. As you can see, he's not moving up yet, which I probably would have done support this.
We are taking damage
against the entirely infantry based army, especially when you're at kind of like a choke point here. These hellhounds are going to do a ton of damage. As you can see, one of my squads are already broken. I think two of them are broken, three of them are broken. The Imperial Guard vehicles are ridiculous. The early game sucks. As you can see, I just wiped the Imperial Guard units. But once you get to this sort of stage, and they get hellhounds, hellhounds are pretty much your anti-infantry. He should be pretty much moving this one out of the way and kind of tanking me, but he's not. He's kind of left it like that. Got another guardian squad here. My allies brought out an essence of the Nightbringer, but not his army quite yet. in order to kind of tank damage for my troops. Except for some reason he activated really early. And yeah, this guy has now kind of got an adrenaline rush. He's gonna flood out and try to expand some more, which turns out to be a very bad idea. He should be thinking about more vehicles at the moment, more guard squads to support. Guard squads in very large numbers once you get the upgrades, and weapons and leaders, etc., can actually do quite a significant amount of damage. People underestimate them because they suck so much early game, but late game they do quite a lot. Me, I'm pretty much healing up all my troops. I think I lost a banshee squad, so that's about it. I didn't really do too bad out of that. And I have a single member left of my third banshee squad. This guy's managed to build a Necron monolith in my base, which is pretty impressive. I completely forgot about that. Luckily, I'm getting the new armor, enchanted reinforced armor, which is going to do a lot good. This is more for ranged weapons, so it's not going to really help my handling banshees, but I pretty much tend to get all the upgrades just in case. Helps with fire dragons, so I'm not too fussed about that. I'm getting some fire prisms out, which are going to be my support units, and because I know this guy, oh, I didn't see that. Basically, he took his hellhounds around here to try and attack the guy next to him on that adrenaline rush and got annihilated. So now I know his hellhounds are kind of temporarily down. I'm just going to rush in and see if I can take out his vehicle production facilities. What he would have been nice to do here was build a few of these, especially since your unit cap as Imperial Guard is built on your mechanized commands. I'm not sure if he thinks that's Chuck. Maybe. Oh, that's Chuck. I think he thought that was Chuck, maybe. That's Chuck up here, doing nothing. For about 10 minutes he's been sat there. Got a lot of stuff, but yeah. He has this relic, so he's gonna probably bring out a monolith. I've got my, what is this? Avatar, that's why. That's why they're going red. And basically, I'm using my avatar here as a scout, pretty much. Because I know these guys have probably got quite a bit of power by now. So this guy's just going to tank it. He's got 15,000 health, which is a lot. So as you can see, the melee damage on this guy is ridiculous. Here's pretty much, it's happening like you'd expect it to. Yeah. I've left his mechanized command alone, because he didn't really seem to be doing much with it. I've also got this fire prism here, so I'm not really too worried about building, destroying his vehicles pretty quick. My ally's sort of stealing all the stuff. And still people are doing nothing. Tau here have got a large, significant force here. Yeah. Broadsides are nice if you're, if your enemy can't get to them, and you're going to be in place for a while. Recruits are always good to tangle up banshees or any either heavy ranged or midi units. He's got his commander up with upgrades, so it's generally pretty good. Commanders are generally... Tau commander's pretty much an all-rounder. He's good at everything. But obviously he doesn't really have the abilities of Necron Lord, so he's kind of at a disadvantage in that kind of way. My avatar's just going to scout out what's up here. These guys are just... He's cloaked most of his force, which is going to be a pain in the ass. And he's also pretty much formed a choke point here with a ton of Necron Warriors. So many Necron Warriors. I'm moving all my force up here after destroying this guy here. And I believe I'm going to attack this guy. I think we're kind of massing up to attack this guy. This was a very bad scenario for us, because obviously this choke point here is going to limit the amount of stuff we can get at him, especially because all our units are going to be backed up on all our units. What I probably should have done here is attempted to see if I could place maybe a Webway Gate either back here, if I bring a Farseer here and then teleport it up, and then just pour in from the back whilst my ally kind of destroys the front. He's got his, his abilities coming down. Got Essence of the Nightbringer here, which is going to draw so much fire. Basically, Essence of the Nightbringer pretty much makes your Necron Lord invulnerable. And they will also soak up a ton of damage. If you have to kind of make your troops avoid targeting them. My avatar is getting stuck in here, destroying a lot of Necrons, but obviously, with Necrons, it's quite significantly hard to actually get rid of them. They will get back up again and again and again, especially with the upgrades. So my avatar goes down. These Tau probably should be hanging back a little bit. Tau are not good in close quarters. This guy is trying to help, but I've managed to tangle up his troops with a Farseer and a Seer Council that I produced like a couple of moments ago from that. I probably should have more vehicles at this point. I've got a Fire Prism out, not really anything else. I'm kind of getting caught up in the moment and not really producing much stuff. Obviously this guy's now got his Monolith out, which is going to be a major defence. But in terms of map control, it's already way too late. We've got allies pouring in from all their respective hidey holes now that they know it's safe to come out. So yeah, my allies coming in to help a little bit here. Essence of the Nightbringer going up is not helping me at all. I simply do not have enough troops here to deal with them. We've got a Guardian squad here, which is not going to do much anyway. Seer Council is obviously 125 to 150 melee. Very nice. And obviously support me here. These guys are going to go down eventually. This guy probably should be realising about now. He's got an energy core, which is probably good, but he can't bring his Monolith online because he doesn't have any relics at all. Kind of nice in the 8-5 map that you only have 4 relics, so you don't have to deal with the big bad Monoliths so much. He's just pouring out Necron Warriors. We've nearly gone down, looks like. This guy's moved up his... I think he's just jump-jetted most of his stuff up. Trying to get behind. And is now trying to take down the Monolith whilst it's still being restored. Yeah, you're going to have to move that out, guy. In terms of late game for Eldar, I feel this is... has kind of been semi-viable. But towards the end, I would be building a lot more... vehicles, especially like walkers. You've got, as you can see, I've got like ridiculous tons of resources at the moment. Not really using my unit caps, so you should be building more web brigades. This was quite a long time ago, probably a couple of years, maybe. So yeah, I wouldn't say this is like the best replay, but it's the only one I have against like proper players that I've actually saved. So think about getting walkers out. Keep your avatar out, your fire prisms. I think I've only got one in the field at the moment, but you can have two. And keep up on your infantry troops. Infantry troops trying to get in way more late game, which is kind of annoying. Obviously, fire prisms have quite a long range, so just keeping them at the back. They're going to be great support for your units. Their main beam will disrupt any infantry you have. And it's pretty good anti-vehicle. Not really a mainly anti-infantry troop. Hi guys, down. Tower player's finishing off. The guy there. Got Necrons coming in. Yeah, that's pretty much the game. Disembarking.
All missiles away! We are taking damage.
One thing to note here, I've Necron player in my base. Yeah. As you can see, I've only just realised. Which is terrible. But yeah, I think this is more like a last ditch attempt. And they're gonna go down. As you can see, what I believe this guy's done here is he's got his Necron Lord and just resurrected most of his troops in this battle. As you can see, they're all on low health. That is from the resurrection. Resurrection ability, especially like in chokeholds like this, where all your warriors die in one place, is a pain. You kind of know where you can get around it from other races, except for like avoid fighting Necrons and choke points. A tip if you're Eldar fighting Necrons on maps like these, when they go towards your base, obviously they have like their Monolith, they have all their support troops. Grab a Farseer, run next to the base, build a web brigade. Then when they get to your base is already teleported away, like if you use the relocation upgrade on the web brigades. So for example, I'd try to put my stuff around here. Probably should have, like, I might have ended up putting it up here instead. And then, obviously, you can just teleport in your troops here and destroy their base. Necrons have a very specific order to what they build. They build, like, summoning calls, advanced summoning calls, Forbidden Archives, energy core, and so they also rely on the power, and the power has to be in one place. Unless they try and spread themselves up, which is really hard if you're a Necron player. So if you go into their base and just destroy their power generators, and basically like one or two in the chain, so maybe the energy core, summoning core, they won't be able to bring up a monolith because they need that chain of things. They also won't be able to build quite a lot of their units because you've broken the chain. Though they will obviously like be able to build some units if they got part of the chain. But obviously, if they want to build their monolith or any advanced troops again, they will have to build up that chain and replace the missing links. So obviously, they've got the monolith and the infantry units running around near your base. But you've destroyed all their backup, so all you have to do now is pretty much do attrition on their moving army. You can keep moving your base around and just take out their army, keep going capturing their points as well, so they build slower. And that's pretty much how to deal with Necron play on big maps if they were playing seriously. These guys are pretty much turtles, so yeah, you're never going to win a game as a turtle, really. Unless maybe you're Imperial Guard. And you can play Imperial Guard well, which is significantly hard to do. So it's pretty much, at the moment, just dealing with his leftovers. Avatar's just being a beast there. And yeah. So, probably Necron players, I'd advise you to play sort of like this guy, but more aggressive. Especially early game, get your Necron Lord out. Start just walking into their base. Necron, especially with Necron players, grab your Necron Lord. If your Necron Lord gets low, teleport him away. If your Necron Warriors get low, there's an ability to teleport back to your buildings. So, Necron players in this game would be, at their best, this would have been, match probably would have gone far against us. Simply because they have more Necron players. And Necrons, especially like when you got a large amount of Necrons, are killer. But as it stands, that's essentially how you kind of try to play an Eldar match against multiplayer people. Just obviously do it better, do it faster.